draws me to these kinds of mathematical forms is that infinitesimally small. My mind really likes that. It's more concrete, it's more tangible, because you can fit in infinity in the palm of your hand.
You know, I can't say if this is the first time that a fractal's ever been machined into metal. I certainly haven't seen it. I like the idea of doing things that haven't been done before. I saw Rob's work on his social media pages. They call it a mathscaper.
We make pieces of fine art that are derived from mathematics. Fractals are some of what we do. We've worked initially with wood, partially because it's inexpensive, and also because it machines really easy and fast. But wood has serious limitations. It won't hold a lot of detail.
Of course, you know, being a metal fabricator, I think, okay, that would be cool if it was made from metal, you know. In my mind, anything that's made from metal is cooler, but, you know, I may be biased.
Moving into harder materials like metal allow us to really go crazy with detail.
In this case here, we used a block of 6061 aluminum. Has some really interesting qualities in terms of its reflective nature and what have you. It's sort of that monochromatic look that you can get.
I think my primary concern going into it was that whoever was going to partner, a la Joe, would require a lot of patience.
There's reasons why people don't necessarily do this type of thing. Takes a hell of a lot of machine time.
The complexity of these parts is immense. You know, it can be many tens of hours, even north of 100 hours for some of these pieces.
You know, the rough out pass went pretty fast. I think it was only 45 minutes. The second pass took about 4 hours, and the final pass on it, I think that took 16 hours, although I don't know, it could have been more, I wasn't paying attention. All I know, when I came in the next afternoon, it was still running. You know, with these things that I've never done before, you have an idea and you think it's going to be cool, but you're not quite sure, you know? As soon as you see the piece on the mill, you're like, oh yeah, that's a win.
I'm blown away. We first walked in today to see the results, my heart just leapt. The way that the reflections come off of a metal after it's been cut, with the tool marks and everything included, really has added dimension to what is already a three-dimensional art form.
The base for the fractal art piece, I intentionally held off on that because I wanted to work with Rob to make sure that he agreed with the form and the shape and how it was presented. Thought is that we'd put some sort of fabricated base underneath there.
I could see us doing some sleeves and standoffs so this thing floats in space.
We're very much on the same page that we wanted to lift this thing off the surface a little bit so we can get that reed all the way around of that broken edge.
I like it there. That's 1¾ inches, roughly.
Okay. In terms of what we used below there, we just used a piece of cold rolled steel and some pipe standoffs and some 3/8 bolts that were tapped into the underside of the block. Overall, the project was a success for sure. it's great when the part turns out and turns out to be as interesting as you were hoping it would be.
You know, we started this in a pandemic. You know, virtually nobody has seen these pieces in real life. So we're really looking forward to opportunities to show in galleries and to get more pieces of public art out there so that we can make beautiful mathematical pieces for all.